there's a lot of stuff going on in the attacker community. One of the things that I do is I analyze large-scale intrusions. So when a bad guy gets into an environment and grabs, you know, hundreds of thousands of credit cards, I help with that incident response, but I also do some expert witness work to kind of see what the attackers did. And some of the really big things we're seeing attackers do now are using different command and control channels. It's called C2. And there's so many different ways that bad guys can control systems once they've compromised them, and they'll take advantage of all these different tools and techniques to do that. Another big thing they're doing hand in hand with that is called living off the land. So rather than installing my own malware on a target system as an attacker, that might get detected, that might have a SOC analyst find that. Instead, I'll live off the land. I'll use the features and capabilities of the operating system itself as my attack tools. So I'm essentially turning Windows or Linux or Mac OS against itself and against other systems on the network. It's a lot stealthier and harder to detect because there's no separate malware that's being put on there. And let's face it, I mean, these systems are built to be, you know, operational and maintained by system administrators. So the bad guy will system administer the machine using the same tools and techniques that legitimate system administrators do. Another big thing that I'm seeing is really deep persistence. I mean, persistence at the level of the USB cable. There are USB cables that you can get now where there is malware that's in the head of the cable itself. So if you plug it into your computer, it works just like a regular USB cable would, but it's actually got malware that's injected into your system. So if you're walking down the street, you see a USB cable sitting there, you pick that thing up, you think you just got a free USB cable. You plug it into your computer, it infects your computer. You don't know how the infection got there, so you clean it up, you plug that cable in again because you want to charge your phone, you're reinfected. Because the attacks are proliferating and they're getting much more subtle, it's awareness of their people. Both rank and file end users, security awareness, but also their security professionals. They need to understand what the latest attacks are. That's why we bring every year our SANS panel to RSA Conference and say, look, here's what we're seeing so that you can look for this in your environment. And making your professionals aware of what the latest attacks are so they can see them while they're happening. I mean, the theme this year, right? It's the human element. What a great theme for the RSA Conference. Yes, machine learning, yes, AI is starting to help. It's augmenting what the humans can do, but fundamentally, the humans have to win this battle. I really look forward to RSA Conference every year. It's one of my favorite places to go. I travel a lot, I go to a lot of events, but this is the one. First of all, it's the big one, right? I mean, it's the biggest event that our industry has. So seeing everyone, that's really nice, but everyone will tell you that. There's two specific areas, though, that I really look forward to. One is the big kickoff, right? They usually have somebody come in from the outside, somebody that you recognize. George Takei was there this year. And they give an inspirational speech followed by several keynote speeches. And I'm something of a connoisseur of those speeches. I watch them, you know, and just really focus and think about how they cohere together. What do they mean for the industry? This year's keynote speeches in that initial keynote kickoff on Tuesday morning were some of the best I've ever seen. And it all the way goes up to the cryptographers panel, which was awesome this year. So good. I feel like a kid on Christmas morning. The second thing is RSA Conference does this thing where they bring scholars, undergraduates as well as graduate students from colleges around the country and perhaps around the world, and they bring them together and they send them to the conference. And so they're young people, typically. Some of them are a little older, but they are bright-eyed, bushy-tailed. They're absolutely brilliant, so excited, and they invite some of us to go to a dinner with them. So it'll be me and one other person, you know, in the professional community with six or seven of these students. I love it. It is so cool. Here in the students, you know, we ask them, what are you working on? What are you thinking about? Do you have a job lined up already or not? You know, what does your world look like? And they come from all different areas. You know, some are focused on really deep technology stuff. Some are, you know, software developers. Some are more on sort of the social aspects of cybersecurity. Again, the human element. And just sitting there and interacting with the students and seeing their excitement, it's infectious. I walk away from that dinner like on cloud nine. I'm so thankful for RSA Conference and the ability to come out here to learn and to also share ideas from what I'm seeing. There's nothing else in the industry at this magnitude with this set of people that can come together and share the ideas about the human element. It is a tremendous value.